Are you all happy? Students, in this class, I am going to teach you a beautiful lesson. It is all about two friends. Okay? Do you all have friends? Of course, you all have friends. In the same way, there are two men living during the period of a Mughal Empire. Okay? And these two men are very thick and best friends. And these two were addicted in playing the chess game. Okay? Do you know how to play chess? Yes or no? How many columns and rows will be there in a chessboard? Have you ever counted it? Okay. Students, these two men, these two friends are addicted to play the chess game. And finally, this game killed both of them. Okay? Are you so excited about the story? These two friends were playing the chess game and the chess game killed those men. Just think about the condition. The title of the lesson you are going to learn today is The Chess Players. What's the title? The Chess Players. Who are the chess players here? Misra Sajjan and Mir Roshan. Misra Sajjan and Mir Roshan. Misra Sajjan and Mir Roshan. These two are the friends. And these two men are the chess players. Okay? Who are they? Misra Sajjan and Mir Roshan. Okay? These two are the friends. These two are the chess players mentioned here in the title. And these two men are Jagirdars. What is meant by Jagirdars? Jagirdars are the landowners of a particular district. And this particular land was given by the king or the British rulers. Okay? So they are like Zamindars. Okay? Jagirdars are also called as Zamindars. So there were many Jagirdars there in the kingdom of Awadh. Okay? This Awadh was ruled by a king named Wajid Ali Shah. Wajid Ali Shah is the last king of Awadh. Okay? Wajid Ali Shah is the last king of Awadh. And this Awadh now is located in Uttar Pradesh. Okay? In the Indian map, if we see the location of this Awadh, it is in the Uttar Pradesh. Where is Awadh? In Uttar Pradesh. Who is the last king of Awadh? Wajid Ali Shah. So Wajid Ali Shah is ruling the kingdom of Awadh, and these two, Sajjan and Roshan, these two men are the Jagirdars there. Okay? These two men were addicted to playing the chess game. Because during the kingdom of Wajid, people enjoyed their life completely. They have no worries. They enjoyed their life completely. Okay? So people gave more importance to the pleasures of life. Like gambling. Okay? They don't want to worry about anything because Wajid Ali Shah ruled the people perfectly. So they have no worries. The only duty of the people is to enjoy their life. So this Jagirdars like Misra Sajjan and Roshan, they have no worries or concern towards the people, towards the subjects. Okay? They never care about them. Their only motive is to play the chess game. That's all. Okay? So nobody cares about anything. They just enjoy their life. The people, the subjects enjoy their life. The Jagirdars like Sajjan and Roshan, they enjoy their life. And later, the wives of Sajjan and Roshan, they advise, they are telling that if you are playing the chess game like this, one day it will kill you. Okay? Too much of anything is good. they are repeatedly telling them that please don't addicted towards this game. You have more responsibilities. Jagirdars has more responsibilities to take care of the villages. But these two men, they have no worries or they don't care about the people, and they are always busy in playing the chess game. So their wives are worrying where it will take them. And finally, these two men got angry. They left the place and they shifted their play area to another old mosque. Okay. So these two men were playing there. And finally, in the meantime, what happened? This Wajid was captured by another king. This Wajid was a soft and kind king. And he was captured by another king. But these two, Jagirdar Sajjad and Roshan, has no worries, and they were looking at the people and they are discussing that Wajid was captured. But still, they didn't take any action. They have full concentration in only on their chess game. Okay. And finally, in the chess game, started their fight. Okay. One among them dominated the other. Then finally, ego and some clash to save the queen or to save the king and queen in the chess game, they killed each other. Who killed each other? Sajjad and Roshan. In reality, they have to safeguard, they have to protect the king Wajid. They have no worries about King Wajid, but they are worrying about the king and queen in the chess game. And finally, they killed each other and thus they lost their life. This is all about the story, the chess players. Is that clear, students? Now can you understand just the outline of this particular story? There are three central characters here, Mr. Sajjad and Mr. Roshan. They are Jagirdars, and Wajid Ali Shah is the king of Awadh. Okay?
Students, now take your textbook. Take page number 107. Page number 107. Danpat Roy Srivatsava. Danpat Roy Srivatsava, better known as Munshi Premchand. So this Danpat Roy is popularly known as Munshi Premchand, is regarded as one of the most prolific Indian writers, thinkers and social reformers of the early 20th century. What is meant by prolific? Prolific means abundance. He has written many works, and he is a social reformer also. He has more concern towards our society during early 20th century. His works including several novels, short stories and essays in Hindi as well as Urdu carry important social messages about the evils of practices such as arranged marriages and the exploitation of struggling farmers by moneylenders that was widespread during his lifetime. So he has written several novels, short stories and essays in Hindi and also in Urdu language. And his works mainly concern about the evil practices in our society, like arranged marriage. Arranged marriage in the sense child marriage, or okay, that is the arranged marriage problems, dowry system and the exploitation of struggling farmers by moneylenders. Moneylenders, because of the moneylenders, the farmers are struggling day by day. Okay. And all such societal problems were touched by Danpat Roy Srivatsava or Munshi Premchand. His short stories, were collected into a book titled Mansarovar, and his novels include works such as Rangabhoomi and Godan. So his short story collection, the anthology of short stories, was entitled as Mansarovar, and his novels include Rangabhoomi and Godan. These are few information about Munshi Premchand. Okay. Now take page number 101. Students, do you know when the chess game was invented? Chess game was invented in the 6th century AD in India. So we should feel proud, right? Chess game was invented during the 6th century in India as Chaturanga, modeled after the four divisions of the military. And it was basically, its foundation is based on the four divisions of the military. What are the four divisions of the military? Do you know that? All right. Okay. Now, let me read the text. It was in the time of Wajid Ali Shah. Lucknow was drowned in pleasure. The big and small, the rich and the poor, all were sunk in it. Love of pleasure dominated every aspect of life. The state officials were absorbed in fun and pleasure. From the king to the pauper, all were engrossed, playing games like chess or cards, or Ganjifa sharpens the mind, improves mental faculties, and helps in solving complex problems. So during Wajid Ali Shah's period, what people are doing, people are enjoying their life. They are giving more importance to the pleasures of their life. All the authorities, all the government officials, they had no concern towards the people, how they are living, how they are surviving. Is there any problem for the people? Is there any problem for this subject? They didn't care about that, and they only, or their main focus is to enjoy their life. Okay, so they were playing games like chess and card. Do you know what is Ganjifa? Find out. Okay, and it helps them to improve, sharpen their mind. Chess game and all, we have to think. Am I right? There is no need of our physical energy, but we need a mental fitness. We need to sharpen our mind. Then it also improves our mental faculties and helps us to solve complex problems. So during Wajid Ali Shah's period, people, especially the authorities, they have no concern towards, they have no concern towards the people, towards their subject. Okay. Next, such arguments were being forcefully advanced. So if Mizra Sajjad Ali and Mir Roshan Ali spent most of their time sharpening their wits, how could any thoughtful person take exception? Both of them were hereditary jagirdars, free from the worries of a livelihood. They enjoyed their good food without having to work at all. What else could they do? So Mizra Sajjad and Mir Roshan Ali, both of them were hereditary jagirdars. Who are the jagirdars? Owners of land granted to their ancestors, to their grandparents by a ruler, by a king maybe. Okay, so the kings or queens or the rulers, they will hand over few lands to some people, and they will govern and they will rule their villages. Okay, these Zagirdars. Zagirdars are like zamindars. Okay. They are the owners of land or the landowners. And these lands were provided by the king. So, this Misra Sajjad and Roshan Ali, they don't want to work. They have nothing to do in this world. They have all the treasures or they are rich people. So, no need to work, just like the farmers. Okay. So, they are happily, they are enjoying their life and their leisure time, always 24/7, they are free. So, they are concentrating only in the chess game. Who are concentrating? Misra Sajjad and Mir Roshan Ali. Misra Sajjad Ali, Mir Roshan Ali. In the morning, after breakfast, both the friends would spread the chessboard, set up the pieces and engage themselves in the tactics of chessboard warfare. So every day after the breakfast, Sajjad and Roshan, they sat together and spread the chessboard and they'll start to play. Repeated messages from inside that food was ready were ignored and the cook was forced to serve food right there in the room as the two friends continued their play. So often or repeatedly, the messengers will inform that food is ready. Come for lunch, come for breakfast, come for dinner, come for supper. But they don't care about that. So finally, the cook was forced to serve the food where they are playing. Members of Mirza's family were far from pleased. So members of Mirza's family, Sajjad's family members are not happy by this chess game. Even the neighbors and servants made uncharitable comments. This is an inauspicious game and can ruin families. So their neighbors, their family members, they all command against this chess game and they are telling that this is an inauspicious game. What is meant by inauspicious? Showing signs that the future will not be good. From morning till evening, if we are playing, what will happen? What about our future? God has created each one of us with a purpose. But if you are playing all the time, what will happen? So their neighbors are commanding against Mirza and they are telling that one day it will ruin, it will spoil the family. There was great disorder in the kingdom of Awadh. People were being robbed in broad daylight. So now the disaster started in the kingdom. What's happening there? People are robbed in broad daylight. During the daytime, they were thieves and they are robbing everything. There was no one who cared. Because the Zagirdars are not worrying about anything and no one is there to take care. So, the robbers ruled the villages. All the wealth from the countryside was being sucked into Lucknow. Now, the kingdom of Awadh is under the control of Lucknow. So, the wealth of the countryside, wealth of the village was taken to Lucknow. The blanket of debt to the English company was becoming wetter and heavier every day. Now, in Lucknow, Britishers are there and the wealth of the village, the kingdom of Awadh is taken by Lucknow, taken by the Britishers. So, they have to pay debt, they have to pay tax to the Britishers and this tax and the debt is increasing day by day. Why is this happening? This is happening because of the absence of good administration. The taxes were not being collected fully. Now there was a great disaster. Things were robbed and all the luxuries, all the treasures of the village was taken by the British rulers, and the debt, the tax was heavy. Now people are unable to pay their debts, pay their tax. Nobody is there to take care of them. Nevertheless, months passed and the game of chess went on in Mir Sahib's Diwankhana. What is meant by Diwankhana? Now they are in Mir Sahib's place. The newest strategies were being charted. There would be arguments and accusations, but soon the two friends would be reconciled. What is meant by that? Became friends again after an argument or a disagreement. These two friends, Sajjad and Roshan, often they argue if one of them failed in one of the matches, and he will argue with the other. Okay. Often they'll fight with each other, and again after few minutes they'll be friends again. Sometimes the game would be terminated midway, and Mirza Sahib would walk out and go home, and Mir Sahib would go inside. Sometimes they'll stop the game in between. What is meant by terminating? Stopping. Okay, they stop the game in the middle and they'll argue. One of them go back and Mir Sahib will go inside his house, inside his castle. But the night's sleep would dissolve the last day's resentment, and the next morning the two friends would be back in the Diwankhana. It's like the auditorium or the hall in the castle. Okay, so sometimes their fight will reach its peak, and in the night time it will dissolve. Okay, morning they'll fight, evening they'll become friends again. One day the two friends were met in the quicksand of a game when an officer of the king's army came riding on a horse asking for Mir Sahib. One day when these two friends were playing the chess game, an officer from the king's army came to meet Mir Sahib. Mir Sahib and Sajjad and Roshan, they both were Zagirdars. So the king's army, one of the officers from the king's army, he came to meet Mir Sahib. Mir Sahib was stunned. What was this? Why this summons? This was not good. From the next day, they would leave before dawn with a small mat under their arms, holding a box full of pounds, full of that coins. The two friends would make their way across the river Gomti to an old deserted mosque that had been built perhaps by Asif ud Dawla. Now, an officer came from King's army and he informed that Mir Sahib wants to meet the king. So this Mir Sahib is not willing to meet the king and he is not ready to do the official duties. Zagirdars has their own duties in their village, but these two men, Sajjad and Roshan, these two are not willing to do their duties, and that's why they are ignoring everything. And the next day before sunrise or before the dawn, in the early morning itself, they both escaped from the village. And where did they go? They crossed the Gomti River and they settled themselves in an old deserted mosque. Deserted means isolated. Nobody is there in that mosque. Nobody is using that mosque. So, old, deserted, abandoned mosque. And this mosque, what is meant by mosque? Just like church and temple, worshipping God. It's a place to worship God. So this old deserted mosque might have built by Asif ud Dawla. Okay, perhaps. So they are not sure about Asif ud Dawla. They are thinking that this old deserted mosque was built by or built during Asif ud Dawla's period. Okay, now why these two men, Sajjad and Roshan, they left the place and they settled in this old deserted mosque? Because they don't want to do their works, do their duties. They want to escape from their duties, from their responsibilities, and their only aim is to play the chess game. They would start playing, then they would forget the world. So now nobody will be there to disturb these two men, Sajjad and Roshan. Okay, nobody will disturb. So they will start their game and they'll forget the world and their responsibilities and their duties. No other words except check and mate would come out of their mouths. So only they won't speak anything at all, but they'll speak only two words. What are they? Check and mate. Students, do you all know to play the chess game? There are many rules to be followed, right? Okay, one day we shall play the chess game, all right? Now, no yogi would be so focused in his meditation as these two. Here, the writer is saying, Sajjad and Roshan, they are concentrating in this chess game more than a yogi who is focusing in his meditation. Okay, you all know who is a yogi, a hermit. Okay, so their concentration is better than yogi's concentration, yogi's focus in their meditation. When in the afternoon they felt angry, when in the afternoon they felt hungry, they would go to an eatery and eat something. Eatery, it's like a dhaba, it's like a small hotel, and eat something, relax for a while, and then restart their play. Whenever they feel hungry, they'll go and eat something and then come back, they'll start their own game. Sometimes they would forget even to eat. Sometimes they will forget to eat. Just think about the condition of these two men. Just like we people, always we are looking at our mobile phone, we are gazing and or playing some games in the mobile phone, right? In the same way, in those days there were no mobile phone. That's why these people were playing chess game. If they had mobile phone, what would happen? Always they will play in their smartphones. Okay, so the condition of these two men and the people who are living now in this 21st century is same, right? They were addicted in playing the chess game. We people are addicted for what? Very good, mobile phone. Okay, till this can you understand, students? So during Wajid Ali Shah's period, people were enjoying their life. They gave more importance to the pleasures of life. They don't want to worry about anything. And the rulers, the Zagirdars, they didn't care about the people. They didn't care about the villages. And they were focusing only on playing chess game or cards or smuggling. And what happened then? Disaster, or the kingdom started to collapse. Okay, Sajjad and Roshan, they don't want to do their, complete their, fulfill their duties and responsibilities. Their only focus is to play the chess game. This is what we have seen in this class. Students, I hope you all have understood today's portion.